palmistry reading of a 27-year-old male. His main questions are regarding career, marriage, education, and questions regarding his family. So these are the questions that we would be dealing out here. Before I start the video, I would request you to press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update. You can get a reading from me, a palmistry paid reading from me. You can call me or you can email me. These are the phone number and the email that are mentioned out here. Now we straight away head to this particular hand image that we have. This is a person whose age is 27, and we would be basically telling whatever good or bad things that we see on his palm. The first thing that comes to our mind out here is that the headline and the lifeline both have got a huge gap in the middle. Whenever there's a huge gap in the middle, it basically signifies that the person is going to be rash and outgoing and never missing out on opportunities. So this person is a go-getter. This person never misses out on any opportunities in his life. So this is the first part. But it doesn't mean that the person who never misses out on opportunities, everything is going to be good for them. We have to take a general view of the whole palm. If we find that the lines are good, I will be describing that particular aspect later in the reading. As it goes by, you would understand what is a good line or a bad line. So you would come to know regarding even in spite of being rash, will the person going to be successful or not? So this is our main whole question out here. So the first good line that we see on his palm is a backward line moving towards the Mount of Jupiter. This is the headline, and there's a backward line moving towards the Mount of Jupiter. This is considered to be a beautiful line. Jupiter planet basically represents higher learning. It represents administration, religion, politics, honor, and it also represents ambition. It means growth. Jupiter being a big planet, it basically increases everything. It basically expands everything. It basically, what it does is that the person is always seeking honor in his life. So if a person has got these particular lines originating from the Mount of Jupiter and joining into the main headline, or the reverse, the headline moving a little bit backwards, we can say both ways, the meaning is basically the same. So it means that the head is getting guided by Jupiter with this particular line, and the person is going to be expansionist. His whole mind is always going to be how to grow further in his life. So this particular attitude in turn brings success. So you have to have the right qualities inside you, only then you are going to be successful. So this is a beautiful sign. Apart from this particular Jupiter line that you have from the headline, as such, if we zoom in into the headline, you would find that the line is very distinct and clear. A distinct and clear line signifies that the person is going to be extremely clear-headed. There are no island-like formations. There are no breaks on the headline. Some people have got breaks out here. So it basically signifies inconsistency. We don't find any such line out here in this particular person's case whose age is 27. Very minor kind of lines. This is the area of Mars negative. Mars negative is the area of anger, aggression, and fire. So this particular area should be a good area. By good area, we mean to say no, we shouldn't be seeing any grill-like formation. Grill-like formation or crisscrossing lines decreases the quality of any particular mount, and same goes with the mount of Mars negative. We don't find as such any negative sign, but in a very small degree, there's a small line that is coming and touching the headline somewhere after the intersection of the money and headline. So this intersection is age 35. So after the age of 35 on the headline, there's a small line that is coming and touching from the Mount of Mars somewhere out here. So this time, this intersection is age 35. of the money and the headline. So this portion could be around the age of 38, 37, 38. That's the approximate. But as such, the line of head is not getting damaged. It is not wavering. It is not breaking. So nothing is happening. And even if we see the intensity of this particular line, if we notice the intensity of the trouble line, even this is very small. This is very minor. So we are kind of going to ignore this negative aspect completely. Now we move on to the other good line that we see on the palm. Generally, I want to, before I tell about the heart line, I was basically going to the heart line. I would basically stop myself and move towards first the money line, because this is what everybody wants their money line to be analyzed. So first I'm going to analyze the money line and then move to the other lines. Money line, beforehand, I would say that money line doesn't tell everything about money aspect. It can tell only 10, 15, 20% of how much money we might make in our life. So it's not just money line which can tell about the money part. Even your headline, this upward line from the headline towards the Jupiter, although Jupiter is not for money, Jupiter is for basically honor. So a person who's seeking honor would reach honor, and once he is at an honorable position, money is no criteria for him. So money basically would easily come to this particular person. So it's not one line, the money line, the fate line, the Saturn line. This is not the only line to talk about the money part. So as such, if we find the money line is reasonably good, and it basically signifies that there is going to be stability. It appears somewhere close to the headline. It appears that the line is breaking out here and a new one is developing, but it's very close by. It's a very close call. We can't really say with certainty that the line of fate is breaking somewhere at the age of 35. There could be a break, there might not be a break. So it's not going to be something very major that might happen to this particular person at the age of 35. It's going to be very minor. For a brief time, I'm just going to take a look at the left hand as well. Just trying to correlate what the left hand is indicating. Does the left hand also indicate a break somewhere at this particular intersection? There is no break as such out here, so that's the reason I would say nothing abnormal is going to happen out here. Now we just move back to the right hand. So this is the hand we are referring to. So this point is age 35. The intersection of the money and the heart line is age 53. This portion is after the age of 53. This portion is 35 to 53. Just remember that. So somewhere in the middle, you would notice this is 35, this is 53. So somewhere in the middle, at the age of 44, the line of money, the line of fate is splitting into two and forming a V or a Y, whatever you can call it. It is pointing towards the fingers. Pointing towards his fingers is always good, a V or a Y. It basically signifies that it's something like, I'm just going to describe what it basically means. Energies or rays are penetrating the fingers, and they are basically entering the palm. When they enter the palm, it means they enter your life, and then they get accumulated somewhere in this particular V. So this point becomes a significant period where a V or a Y is getting formed. So the timing is approximately 44, when things are going to become even better. Towards the end, the line is neat and clean. So the person can expect good possibilities in when he's older, after the age of 53 as well. There should not be too many lines over the amount of Saturn. There are not too many lines over it, just a distinct line, something like this. It's a good indication. Some people have crisscrossing kind of lines. That area basically gets disturbed, overworked, and that plays as a negative aspect. Now, money line is not the only line to read about the money. As I've already explained, we would take another look at the hand and try to find any good sign on this particular hand. So we find a good Mercury line. Even these lines are Mercury lines, two or three lines, these are Mercury lines. Any line pointing towards the amount of Mercury is considered to be a Mercury line. These lines could also be called the Mercury line. So, but we would just concentrate on this particular line. This line in itself is perfect. So a deep and distinct Mercury line signifies good set of skill. So a person who has good set of skills, the chances of that person making good amount of money increases. So this is what is represented by a strong Mercury line. You would notice even strong Mercury lines under the finger. And they are not one but multiple, 3, 4, 5 out here. So it's not that you should have 3 or 4 or 5, only then you are going to be successful. Even one single line can bring about success. But multiple Mercury line signifies that the person, if a person tries to be a doctor, he can be a good doctor. This is what the book says. This is not what I say. I basically interpret these lines to be the line of skill. One line represents one skill, two lines represents two, four lines, four, five lines, five set of skills. So you don't need to have so many set of skills. Even one set of skills is good enough for success. Now, too many lines out here means multiple set of skills the person has. Even this is reasonably okay. There's nothing wrong with it. Provided it's deep and clear, these are reasonably deep and clear. They could have been much more deeper. If they were more deeper, I would say that the person is sharpening his skills even further. The good part about these lines are that they are not intermingling and crossing each other out here. So if they were crossing each other, it would basically signify miscommunication, miscalculation. We don't find any such thing out here. It means that the person is very good at drafting skills, at very good at calculations and communication, very distinct communication that this particular person has. So in a way, this area is also representative of networking skills. Engineering, medical, law, mathematics, statistics, business, anything you can name, these represents these kind of skills. Now we move to the sun line. The sun line is any line moving towards the mount of sun is basically the sun line. It's very dim, unclear out here. Beyond the heart line, this is the heart line. Beyond the heart line, only on this particular mount we find that the lines of line of sun is becoming a little bit more distinct and clear. And there's a V or a Y like getting formed. One is pointing towards Mercury and the others are pointing towards sun. So when there's a V or a Y kind of pointing towards two fingers, the quality of the other mount also comes to the sun line. So in a way, there's nothing wrong with it. This is a good indication, but it should have been much more distinct and clear. The clearer it is, the better it is considered to be. You'd notice, I'm just going to draw the line once more, just this whole line. This is the headline and this is the heart line. So this portion is before the age of 35, this portion is 35 to 53, and this portion is 53 and beyond. So you'd notice that it's very dim and unclear somewhere out here from the age of, let's say, 32 to 30 to the age of 53. It's very dim, unclear. Beyond that, it's reasonably okay. But dim lines basically signify that the person is in self-doubt. It is said self-doubt destroys everything. So I would advise this particular person to remove any doubt, self-doubt that the person has. The person may say that he has got self-doubt. The person may say the person doesn't have self-doubt. Right now, at this particular age, the person has got reasonably good, strong sun line. This is reasonably good, but beyond that, it's not so clear. But at the same time, now the person is going to get thinking that there's no success. Without sun line, there's no success. It's not like that you need to have a sun line to be successful. Even in spite of having no sun line at all, people are having world fame and they are super rich. They are billionaires. So don't think billionaires would be having very strong line of sun. They need not have a very long line of sun. It's not necessary at all. But what I've told you, removal of doubts is necessary. That is going to help in your career. It's again, one more thing I need to add out here. Don't think that just the sun line would make your career bright or dim. It's a combination of each and every line on the palm. As I've just explained, regarding the money line. Money line can't tell everything, same as the sun line can't tell everything about your career. So it's a combination of Mercury. Mount is good, upward lines on the Mount of Jupiter, strong headline, strong money line. So it's a combination of all these things basically can make or break that particular person. So other indications are good, although sun line is not so good. Now we move to one of the most important lines that I consider, not everybody consider, but I consider as the line for success. And if this line is good, everything is good basically in the end. I look no further. I talk about the heart line. This is the heart line. The first thing is that the heart line is curving a little bit inward towards the fingers. Curving towards the finger is always good. And curvature in the heart line signifies that the person is passionate. The person displays his emotions. And the person is likely to display his emotion. The person could be a little bit temperamental. If this was a little bit more curved, I would have said more temperamental, more expressive. But it's the person is reasonably expressive with his emotion. The second thing is heart line. People will think that heart line is going to tell me about my emotional life, my love life, my married life. It's not like it's only going to tell about these things. It can tell even your work life. So regarding the work life, when the heart line ends on the Mount of Saturn, this is the best sign for money, money management. The person values money. The person is very good at managing money. See, every businessman or even people in service who make good amount of money, you would notice their heart line ends on the Mount of Saturn. It basically signifies where you are giving your heart. See, some people, they might have a long heart line. Long heart line means idealism and sensitivity. The person doesn't value money. But in this case, this person values money. For him, money is important. Saturn also represents wisdom and money management and being grounded, knowing the ground situation very well. So all these qualities come to this particular person, and that's the reason why the person is likely to be more successful because of these qualities. Now we come to the other very good important point that I see on the heartline. The heartline is very simple kind, very simple, deep and clear. If you take a look at most successful people, you'd find this kind of a line. It means that the person is not anxiety prone. The person does not get distracted. If the heartline was breaking something like this, it would mean constantly getting distracted. Sometimes being in a food business, abruptly ending the food business, joining the computer business, then abruptly ending the computer business, joining something else. So this is not what is represented in this particular hand. The person is committed. The person does not get distracted. The person is not flirtatious. The person is able to offer his life to one particular cause. This is what brings success. So this is perfect in this sense. And at the same time, it's a balance kind of a head and heart line. So a balance between the head and the heart line. Yeah, and the reasonably equal length and all these things are reasonably okay. So it's a good sign. Because balanced personality is able to correlate with more people than unbalanced personality. Some people don't have a good balanced kind of a head and heart line. That's the reason why their nature is very different. If you just take a look at the hand, you would notice what portion of the hand appears to be coming to prominence. Normally, this is the area where people have a prominent Venus. But out here, we don't see that particular. What is more prominent out here is this particular area, the area of Jupiter. And Jupiter area, whenever prominent in any person's hand, is a very good sign. It basically signifies the qualities I have already told you regarding Jupiter. It is the area of higher learning. It is the area of spirituality, growth, ambition. It is the area of governance. It is the area of how to organize things. So all these things come to this particular person naturally. It's a natural inclination. This person with this particular line and a good amount of Jupiter would have been heading his junior classes and even senior classes, or he might have been doing something or the other in college or school apart from just education as well. So it's a good sign. Before I end this video, I will just tell about the Mercury, and it appears a little bit short. It's not even touching the ring finger top line. Sometimes the image is not taken in the right way. That's the reason why we can't say with certainty if this is short or not. But assuming it is short, the Mercury finger is short, it basically signifies that the person would create distance between their near and dear ones. Near and dear ones are people who are really close to this particular person. In the earlier period, it's going to be parents, then sister, or sister, brother, or friends, and then wife, and then a children. But at the same time, a short Mercury finger would increase the thirst for knowledge, because this is the area of knowledge. So it would increase the area thirst for knowledge. Now, I have already answered the question regarding his career. Marriage aspect, the only negative aspect that we see out here is a short Mercury finger. Otherwise, it's a very balanced kind of hand. So a person is going to be really predictable kind of good money line. Everything is good. The person needs to communicate with his loved one. So in that way also, he's good. In every way, he's basically good. Just a small thing on the left hand. On the left hand, it appears that the heart line is kind of broken somewhere out here. A small break out here may signify heart or eye related issues. But you need to correlate if the person has got very small, extremely small, very small nail. Only then we can say that heart related issues. Marriage is reasonably good. A few inward kind of lines out here at the start of the headline. So anger and aggression can be there to some extent. Apart from that, if we look closely on the, this is the lifeline. So in the earlier period of the lifeline, there's a small branch going pointing towards the amount of moon. This is a negative line. Anything pointing towards downward is considered to be bad towards the base of the palm. I think that area, that time has already passed, and at the same time, lifeline is also breaking somewhere out here, and a new one is overlapping. So we are not going to consider the left hand as such. We are only going to consider the right hand. But even the overlapping is nothing wrong. Some people have caught up, break something like such a huge break. So don't think that everything is gone. It's not like that. You take a look at Shah Rukh Khan hand, Salman Khan hand. Many people, they have got a break on various lines. It doesn't mean everything ends. And a small break is to be ignored completely. And this break, probably it's happening somewhere close to the age of late 30s. That's the approximate age I would say. And I would end my video out here. But before I end this particular video, I would repeat few things that I repeat in almost all my videos. We can come to know about money from any line, heart line, headline, lifeline, sun line, or sun mount, or Venus, or Mars, or any other line. Importance of money line is just 15%. And the last thing is that a saint once said, you do not need to go to an astrologer or palmist to know about your future, because you already know your future. Present is the result of past. How will be my future? Future depends upon what you are doing in the present. What are we? We are product of our thoughts. So the thoughts that come to our mind are really important. Keep positive thoughts and keep good company, because company matters the most. Thanks for watching this video. Do subscribe to my channel and do give your precious comments down below in the comment section. Thanks, bye, and take care.